my husband and I both grew up in Glens Falls on the same street. So we've known each other since we were 8 and 9. We were vacationing at my uncle's beach house together. And when we were at the beach house is when I discovered my lump in my breast. The day I found out that the lump in my breast was definitely not benign, my father was actually in the hospital recovering from his radical prostatectomy surgery. So my mom and I cried in the breast center and then went upstairs to my dad who was recovering. The first time that we went to the cancer center, my mom had got us set up with Vicki Yatta, the nurse navigator. The moment my husband and my mom and I walked into the cancer center, I knew that this would be home, this is where I was gonna get my treatment, and this felt like the right place for me. I just knew the moment I walked in and how friendly everyone was, and this was the place. So Vicki helped us with every step of the way. She helped us get set up in the boutique when I was going to lose my hair, so she got us set up to get a wig. Every question I had, and she was there for us, no matter if it was at the hospital, phone call, or email, she was always right there for myself, my husband, and my mother. Met with Dr. Florio many times. He was a great help to me. Our sessions meant a lot to me to help me to look forward and stay positive. I also met with a dietitian. I went to support groups, and it was a great network when I had first been diagnosed. It was really nice to meet fellow survivors and to feel like I had a place that understood all of my fears, because my family and friends, I had such an amazing support group, but none of them had had breast cancer. So it was nice to go to the hospital to have a place that understood. I just celebrated my 11-year cancerversary, as we call it. What really got me through and what really saved me was the idea of having a baby. At the time of my diagnosis, my husband and I were starting to think about starting our family, as all of our friends were beginning to have their families, and that's where we thought at that point our lives we would be. And then I found my lump, so we had to put that dream on hold. I knew that I wanted to have this little boy named William Joseph, and that's what got me through, is every moment when I thought I can't go on, this hurts too much, why me? I thought I have to go through this because I'm going to have that little boy. We are going to have our miracle baby. I knew that I wanted to give birth at Glens Falls Hospital. I was born there. All of my friends were having babies there, and this was my hospital. It had saved my life. So I wanted our baby to be born at the hospital, and I knew that I would be safe in this hospital, which is the hospital I received all of my care. And so they really took care of me and were really kind to me and my worries. I never wanted to go anyplace else. I was recommended by several people to go to Dana-Farber or New York City. The moment I met Dr. Stoutenberg, I know that he was the one who was going to save my life, and I had my full trust in him, so I didn't want to go anyplace else. It's such a jewel in our community. We're so lucky to have this. It's such a special place within this amazing hospital. We're so fortunate.